with the latest on the Rizal boat tragedy. The Philippine Coast Guard says it will investigate its own personnel for failing to flag an overloaded motorbangka that capsized off Rizal Province Thursday. The PCG said they will also relieve the Coast Guard personnel at Binangonan Port. The captain of the boat allegedly allowed over 60 passengers to board the vessel despite its 42 seating capacity. At least 26 people are confirmed dead, while 40 other passengers have been rescued. Search and retrieval operations are underway as the Coast Guard has yet to determine the actual number of people who were on board.
As of now, we do not have the actual manifest of the boat because apparently the report that came to us is that upon clearing at the Coast Guard substation in Binangonan, they only declared 22. But when the captain went back to his vessel, people are trying to board the motorbangka. Kasi po, tatlong araw po, wala pong biyahe. Yeah. So many people are, you know, they want to go home.
A survivor claims the delayed response of rescue teams is among the reasons many died in the Rizal boat tragedy. Recalling the fatal incident, Mar de los Reyes says rescuers failed to arrive on time to save passengers who were trapped inside the vessel.
Almost 30 minutes na kami nasa may taas ng bangka.
Oh.
Wala pang tulong.
Wala pang tulong.
Opo, tapos nagkaya niya lang po yung mga taga kalinawan. Yung sa kalinawan, may liit na bangka, nagsuguran, yun po unang tumulong. Dumating po yung mga rescue, almost 1.5 hours na, almost 2 hours na.
Okay,
wala
so...
pong silang nagatnan. Kaya wala pong tag-room, na-revive, wala po.
La.
Talagang lahat patay.
De Los Reyes also claims Coast Guard personnel did not check their boat before they set sail.
At least 13 are reported dead due to Typhoon Egay. Data from the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council also show 20 more are reported missing. The storm affected over 500,000 individuals, with more than 42,000 displaced. Meanwhile, the estimated cost of damage to infrastructure has jumped to over 656 million pesos. Damage to agriculture was pegged at around 58 million. Those numbers are expected to go higher. The province of Cavite is the latest to declare a state of calamity in the aftermath of Egay.
Inclement weather is hampering search operations for 4 missing rescuers of the Philippine Coast Guard. It has been 2 days since the Coast Guard crew went missing after their boat capsized off Abulug in Cagayan. The rescuers were on their way to help crew members of a private tugboat when their own vessel overturned in rough seas Wednesday. The Coast Guard Aviation Force was scheduled to fly out Friday morning, but the operation was suspended due to bad weather.
Ongoing pa rin rescue effort natin. Kasabay, incidentally, nagsabay-sabay yan because of the typhoon. Alam nyo, the north was severely affected by the recent typhoon. So, yeah, even yung mga asset natin, nagpadala rin ako ng asset coming from Manila ng search and rescue teams. Nalaman din natin na merong hindi nakapenetrate, especially in Aurora.
More than 1,600 residents of Baco Oriental, Mindoro were evacuated after torrential rains caused flooding in 23 out of 27 villages, with some areas seeing floods of up to 5 feet deep. Damage to agriculture is initially pegged at 11 million pesos. Baco Mayor Alan Roldan says it is the most severe flooding the town has experienced so far. He asserts flooding would not have happened if the national government expedited the dredging of the town's 2 rivers. Roldan is also appealing for government assistance, saying their 8 million peso calamity fund is not enough.
Abra has been placed under a state of calamity following the effects of Egay. Some areas are still without power as residents begin cleanup efforts. Bianca Dava is in Banged and she filed this report.
Weather is a lot better here in Banged, Abra this morning. As you can see here behind me, some residents are slowly returning to their homes. here in Barangay Santa Rosa, which is one of the villages that was submerged in flood during the onslaught of Super Typhoon Egay. The flood has subsided in most parts of Banged, but when the powerful typhoon slammed Abra on Wednesday, the heavy rains it brought caused floods which trapped some residents on roofs. Not only did Egay sweep away people's belongings, it also destroyed rice and corn fields, which are sources of livelihood of residents. People have now slowly returned to their flooded homes to clean what's left of their belongings and see what can still be used. Mud-covered chairs, cabinets, washing machines, and beds are piled up here on the streets as residents sweep debris and murky water from their houses. People have also started returning their animals to the villages after finding refuge for them in the streets near the town center. The Abra Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, or PDRIMO, said more than 17,000 families or 59,000 individuals are affected by Super Typhoon Egay here in the province. In its assessment on Thursday, the typhoon damaged over 120 houses. Aside from the flood, multiple landslides were also recorded in Abra. Various government agencies are now clearing roads of fallen trees and electric posts. Power lines are still down here in the province, with the Abra provincial capital serving as the charging station of residents. On July 27 last year, the province of Abra was struck by a magnitude 7 earthquake. And a year later, residents here are facing difficulties again, this time with the effects of Super Typhoon Egay. Now, aside from the relief packs from the government, some private individuals have also visited barangays here in Banged Abra to personally give assistance in the form of food, water to those affected.